Hello everyone, in this Photoshop video I want to talk about creating a panoramic image using the Camera Raw Editor and then of course also editing the panoramic image. This process by itself is super easy, but the light for this image is kind of challenging to fix, so I guess this part will be interesting as well. So let's go! By the way, if you want to follow along this tutorial, you can find the RAW files in the description of the video. Here we are in the Camera RAW editor. Down here you can see the different shots I took for this panoramic image. And the very first thing we want to do is to simply merge the panorama. So therefore I'm holding down the Control key and just select all the shots I need for this. Then right click and simply say merge to panorama. So here we get a little preview of the image. You can let Photoshop do the cropping for you. I usually don't do that, so I'm going to deactivate the setting and then you can play around with the boundary warp or even fill the edges. And once you have set up all those options, just hit the merge button. Once that is done, you have the panoramic image in your RAW editor. You can see for this shot I already cropped it a little bit and try to straighten the horizon, but this looks good for now. So at this point we can actually start editing the image. As this is a sunrise shot, the light conditions are kind of hard to work with, especially with just one exposure, but looking at the histogram you can see we have all the details we need. There is no under or overexposure, so that's pretty good. First off, let's just change the profile to Adobe Standard. This will lessen the contrast a bit, so I just have a little more control over it myself. Now in the Basic tab, I also want to change the white balance from as shot to cloudy. This will just give us some more natural color tones to begin with. Now the first thing that I want to change is the sky, since it's kind of blown out at this point. So I'm just going to drop the highlights. This makes the shot a whole lot better already, as you can see. Then next up, let's bring in some contrast by dropping the shadows. Just like that. And let's push the contrast. Okay. At this point, I do think the blacks need to be a little brighter. So I'm going to increase them. This will again lessen the contrast, but I just like the look of it with the increased blacks. Perfect. Then let's see. I do want to add a bit of texture on this shot. And at the same time, I want to drop the clarity slightly. This will give the image a subtle soft look, which I'm aiming for. And finally, of course, you also want to add some vibrance to bring in some color. Okay. At this point, the colors, especially on this field in the foreground, do look a little strange, but we will fix that later. For now, let's work a little more on the exposure, and I'm going to continue by using some local adjustments. For this video, I'm using the newest version of Photoshop, so my local adjustments do look a little bit different. You can see I have already applied a few masks here. Let's start with the first one, which is a linear gradient for the sky. And here I do want to make the sky a little darker at the very top, so I'm going to drop the exposure. I'm actually going to drop it quite heavily. And also I want the top part of the sky to be a lot bluer. So for this reason, I'm going to drop the temperature here. Okay. Okay, and then let's add some clarity just to get some more structure in the clouds. Perfect. That's it for the linear gradient. Now let's work on some extra glow around the sun. Therefore, I have created the mask 2, which is a radial gradient. You can see it's really flat. So with this, I have tried to simulate this gap in the clouds, which is also kind of flat where the sun is coming through. And for the glow, I'm going to simply boost the blacks. I am also dropping the dehaze And now, due to those changes, we did lose a lot of color. That's not looking good this way, so I'm going to boost the temperature. And I also want to have a little more of a magenta in there, so I'm going to boost the tint all the way. Still, I think we are lacking color here. For this reason, I can simply go click on this little box right here. And now choose the color to apply to this area. So let's see, I do want to go into the red range somewhere here. And maybe let's play around with the saturation as well. All right, that looks much better. Then let's work on the center for a moment. Right now, this part is a little too dark. I want to fix that, of course, by bringing up the exposure first. Then I can safely increase the highlights in here as well, and maybe the whites. Also, we could add a bit of contrast in there. Perfect. Now there's another mask for the center part. Again, I want to bring up the whites. And I do want to bring up the temperature to fix this strange looking color in here. It starts to get too saturated. So let's simply drop the saturation. All right, nice. And now there's one final radial gradient, again over the area around the sun. Yeah, I just want to introduce some more warm tones by bringing up the temperature and also adding some color. So let's see what we can do here. That's a pretty nice tone, but let's drop the saturation slightly. All right. Cool, that's it for the local adjustments. Now let's work on the colors for a moment. I'm starting in the color mixer. First off, let me change the hue tones. I really don't like the greens in the foreground since it's kind of fighting against the blue and warmer tones of the sky. So to fix that, I'm going to drop the green hue all the way. And it's instantly looking much more harmonic. Let's also drop the yellow hue just a bit. All right. And then I do want to push the purple hue. And the reason I'm doing this is because of this area in the trees in the back, because there are a lot of purple tones in there, which kind of look not so nice, but I might need to fix it later in Photoshop. For now, let's check the saturation tab. I am going to drop the green saturation first, just like that. And let's push the orange saturation. All right. And let's also introduce some more blue tones. Perfect. Then let's do the split toning. Of course, for the highlights, let's go with a nice warm color tone. That looks good. Let's bring up the saturation. Nice. And for the shadows, I'm not going with a warm color tone, but instead I want to introduce some more blues in here. So this looks good. Let's bring down the saturation though. All right, nice. And the final part of the color grading in the Camera Raw Editor is happening in the calibration tab. Here I'm just playing around with the hues and the saturation of the red, green and blue primaries. First off, I'm going to drop the blue primary. Also, I'm boosting its saturation. I'm going to boost the green hue and the red hue as well. All right, perfect. Then let's sharpen this image real quick. And that's it for the raw adjustments. Now let's finish the editing with Photoshop. First off, I'm going to clean up this image, so I'm using the spot healing brush and zoom in and just get rid of a few things. Alright, now let's enhance glow around the sun a little more. Therefore, I'm creating a new layer, switch the blending mode to soft light, grab the brush tool and set the brush opacity to around 10%. And I'm also grabbing a color from around this area. Now I'm just carefully painting in a little glow here. This also helps to warmen up the sky some more. Perfect. Now I'm not done yet with the glow. I'm going to add another layer, but this time with the hard light blending mode. And with the brush and the same color, I'm going to paint in some more heavy glow. Just like that. And I'm kind of playing around with the brush size as well. So that looks really cool to me. And next up, let's do some dodging. Therefore, I'm creating a new layer, set the blending mode to overlay. And as usual, for the dodging, I'm using the TK panel plugin. In this case, I do want to kind of make those areas in the foreground a little brighter. Therefore, I'm simply applying a Lights 1 layer mask on this overlay layer. And with the brush tool and a white foreground color, I can now safely paint in a little more brightness. Actually, before I start to dodge, I do want to change the vibrance of the foreground in some areas. So right above our panoramic layer, I'm going to create a vibrance adjustment layer. And let's bring down the vibrance here. Then I'm inverting the layer mask by hitting Ctrl I. And then use a white brush to reduce the vibrance of a few areas here. Like this rock on the left side looks way too blue, so I don't want that. Just like that. Now back to the dodging layer. I'm just brightening up a few parts here. Let's brighten up this river as well. All right, much better. Actually, I need to clean up the image a little more up there. And here's a bit of tree as well. Okay, so that looks pretty nice. Let's apply another overlay layer. This time I'm not adding a luminosity mask. Instead, I'm just straight up painting on this layer. That just means the shadows are affected by the brightness as well. Okay, and I can even burn a few areas, I guess. Therefore, I'm using a black brush. And I want to mainly do this to the shadows back there. Okay, let's go back to that vibrance adjustment layer one more time and lessen the saturation in the back over the forest. So we get rid of those strange looking purple tones. Perfect. And at this point, I'm almost done. Now let's merge everything, and then I'm going to check the Nick Collection plugin. For this image, I already have a few filters selected. First off, I want to start with the Brilliance Warm filter, just adding a little warmth and a little saturation to everything, which works great for a sunrise image like this. Then next up, I also add a little bit of glamour glow, which just makes the sunrise a lot softer. And as you can see, I also added a little bit of warmth to the glow. And finally, since I'm still not happy with the foliage in the foreground with all those green tones, I'm going to add the Indian summer filter, which just slightly changes those green tones and just overall gives me a stronger autumn look. Just like that. So let's hit OK. And here we have the final image. So I hope this was interesting and helpful. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments, and thank you very much for watching this video.